Hello, here we are, segment three, Back in Blue, episode 66, talking about Adam Lin this time. Very interesting topic because a lot of people want him to be gone. He's got a team-friendly contract or option, I should say. And Drew just described him. I can't remember what exactly he said, but he's a pretty awesome player. Is that the word?
I think I used an expletive, but yeah. He's pretty good, and I'm tired of trying to tell people that because they don't listen.
Defending him.
Yeah. That's right.
Yeah, I know. You're tired of hearing that. So
everybody wants to bash Lin because he's not 2009.
Let's hear it. Mm-hmm. I want a good Drew rant here.
No, I'm not going to. No, there's no more rants left in me. I'm emotionally checked out. No, this is a guy who's got over 460 at-bats this year. He's third on the team in OPS. Third on the team in slugging, third in total bases, and second in games played. Like I said, he's got a lot of at-bats. And generally, he's hitting pretty good. I mean, he's essentially your third best overall hitter. Now, with Adam Lin, you get extreme flashes of really good and then really bad. And that's what we've seen in the past. But this year, the on-base percentage has pretty much been steady, aside from a couple of months there in the middle of the season. But that is also something that's on the rise. And then again, you have the fact that this is a contract year, essentially, if the team wants to pick up that option, if they want to let him walk. And, you know, like you guys are saying, I mean, there's not really much of an upgrade out there with the power from the left-hand side.
Yeah.
He's looking at 19 home runs now. That's a great guy to have, 19 home runs, when he's getting on base, you know, at 360 clip about, you know.
Yeah.
It's a good player. And like I said, I'm tired of having to explain that to people because they see... They want to focus on the negatives. Yeah, he swings a lot of pitches. Maybe he doesn't hit lefties all that good. He's hit lefties pretty good this year.
He has, and it was at a point where it was probably like bit 50, 51, 52 or something like that. We're saying, are Rasmus and Lin platoon players? Because that seems how the course of the season was going to play out, right?
It now was we've ugly. Seen,
it was, it and was. Both of them really came on.
Yep.
And we should be really happy about that as Blue Jay fans because I want Rasmus here. I'm a Rasmus fan. Yeah. And hearing what Drew, he just sold me for sure.
I was going to say the exact same thing. Drew sold me without a doubt with Lin. Like, exactly. It's all right there staring us in the face.
It is. Sure. And the contract is great. I can't remember the exact number right now, but it is a great team-friendly option. And I mean, I don't know why you'd pass on that for someone like Justin Morneau.
Mm-hmm.
Let's call him Brandon Morneau. Morneau from now a Pittsburgh Pirate, you know, who's going to be a free agent. Like, and maybe he would give the Blue Jays like a, you know, country-friendly contract or something.
He would give the Blue
Jays... He's going to want a lot of money. He's not going to be looking for anything
He would
cheap.
Give them a boost in jersey sales at this point.
Yeah. Right?
Not to
need,
discount anything from the player that he is, but we have a guy in Adam Lin who can provide everything he can do.
Exactly.
Perhaps even more.
Yeah, don't they just kind of seem like the same player?
Well, when it comes to the on-base percentage, I'd say that Adam Lin's probably a little bit better this season, granted. But.
No, well, that's the thing. I mean, Morneau is past his prime. I don't know how many years of MLB service he has now exactly, but he's been a league MVP. He's been a multiple-time All-Star, and he's had injury problems. I mean, Lind, he may not have been the league MVP. He may not have been the team leader that Morneau was, but the fact that he's been, you know, kind of found his groove and he could, you know, maybe steady Eddie going forward.
Yeah.
How about this? How about this comparison? This Adam Lin is a homegrown talent. How much homegrown talent do we actually have on this roster right now?
Yeah, not much.
I hate to really ding that up, but you know what I mean. I mean, even guys like you want to say Laurie is, but Laurie obviously came up with the Brewers, or didn't come to major leagues, but he had a lot of his minor league teeth cutting with the Brewers per se. So I mean, this is a guy who's really a Blue Jay through and through. So I don't understand why everybody's so down on him all the time.
Yeah, it's true. And I always bring up the family aspect of Lin too. He found himself Toronto girls, started his family now,
exactly.
Got a kid, a couple kids, I think.
Yeah,
one or
he
two
wants
now.
To be here.
You know,
right?
He's
that's the thing.
Exactly. He's a Toronto guy, and he's fighting for his role and to keep it and to prove people wrong because. The big thing about him not being able to hit lefties, and but yeah, he's put together a solid season.
Really,
it's good to see, and it's good to see. He's really humble, you know. He was the one that was always pointing out, you know, I don't hit like this all the time. I'm not going to hit like this forever.
Yep.
You know, I've been brutal. He's pointed out how bad he's been.
He
in the
knows
past.
What type of player he is.
He
we
knows.
Know
that's
players.
The reality, though. He can't hide it, and it's good to see because you don't want someone to be delusional and just think that they're, you know, better than they are, or they, you know, they don't have the problems that they do. Right. Mm-hmm. He recognizes his issues. He went down last year to Vegas.
Yeah.
You know, like
remember that.
I think that's really where he turned his little stint there with the Blue Jays, or with the 51s. He was put in touch with Chad Mottola. Chad Mottola's off this year.
Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah, that's
really where
the
on-base percentage spiked for Adam Lind. And he hit really well when he came back up with the Blue Jays last year. He's continued that success into 2013, more or less on a consistent basis, save for I don't know, a couple of months.
Yeah, and I think, like Reed mentioned, he's a family man as well. So it's a big-time wake-up when you get sent down to the minors. And, you know, you're looking at these team options, and, you know, you're going to have nowhere to go in a couple of years, right? So I think it's really great to see that he's at least seems to have resurrected his career.
Oh, yeah. And truly, truly one of the purest hitters on the team. Lynn. Natural hitter.
Yeah, he's really smooth. He's no Johnny O, but, I mean, not many guys are. He's got a sweet left-handed swing.
Absolutely.
For sure. All right, we're wrapping up here. Like I said, it's the Munenori Kawasaki episode of Back in Blue.
66.
That's right. Thanks for joining us. Take it easy.